As Adhiman Matric Higher Secondary School, Othangarai. Dear students in Kingdom Animalia, today we are going to discuss about subphylum of Chordata. Now already we see the what are the character of Chordate phylum. The Chordata divided into three subphylums. That is, one subphylum is called Eurychordata, another subphylum is called Cephalochordata and Vertebrata. But these two subphyla, the Eurychordata and Cephalochordata, now we are going to discuss. Now, dear students, see first subphylum Eurychordata. You know, Euro is always called Horo. Horo means is a Greek word that means a meaning of tail. Okay. Then chordate is a Latin word that means cord. I mean vertebral column. The vertebral column called cord is present only tail. That is why it is called Eurychordata. It is always called as Tunicata. Okay. In this subphylum, organisms all are living in a marine life. That means it is living in a seawater only. So it is otherwise known as sea squids. It is otherwise known as what? Sea squids. Okay. They are sessile in life. That means these organisms are permanently in a particular place only, not moving. So sessile mode of life. But however, some bodies are pelagic and free swimming. That means some organisms only moving from one place to other place. But most of the organisms are permanently placed in a one place. Okay. So these organisms are maybe living in a solitary or individually separately living, or maybe colonial. Colonial means the organisms are grouply living. So it may be living a separately or group. Two modes of life are there. You know, see, the body is unsegmented. There is no divisible or compartment in the organisms of Eurychordata. The body is completely covering by a test or tunic. It's a some special type of coverings are there. That is called a test or tunic. That is why these organisms are called Tunicata. It's covered by a tunic-like covering. That's why it's called Tunicata. Okay, in these organisms are adult, you know, a sad-like appearance, the adult organisms. Okay. And these organisms, the coelom is absent. That means the body cavity is completely absent of this Eurychordata. But however, the arterial cavity present in the throat, you know, in the throat side, there is little bit cavities there. That cavity is called arterial cavity. But no body cavity, but the arterial cavity only present in this Eurychordata. Okay, then see, the notochord, vertebral column that is present on the tail in larval stages of the organism only. In larval stage, the tail region only consisting the notochord. In adult, there is no notochord. So, but tail region of larva consisting the notochord, that's why it is called Eurychordata. Okay. You know, see, the alimentary canal is complete alimentary canal, the complete digestive system is there. Okay. Then circulatory system of these organisms are, see, the open type of circulatory system. There is no blood vessels. But however, there is a ventral side heart is present. That heart is a tubular, is a tube-like nature of the heart, which is present on the ventral side of the organism. Okay, then see, there is a dorsal tubular nerve cord. Okay, present in larval stages only. The nerve cord, you know, is present in a larval stages of organism only. But you know, in adult stage, that nerve cord is completely disappear. Okay, a single ganglion is present in the dorsal side of the adult only. The nerve is completely degenerated. Only a small ganglion present in the dorsal side of the adult organism. Okay, these all organisms are hermaphrodite in nature. You know, hermaphrodite means both male and female organs are present in the same organism. That is called hermaphrodite. So, there is a indirect development is there. That means, indirect development means egg hatches out, larval stage comes. Not a parent-like offspring is not coming. So, indirect development is there in these organisms. Okay. The larva is called free-swimming tadpole larva. And these larva has an chordate characters are present. But here the metamorphosis, retrogressive metamorphosis. Metamorphosis is nothing but the larva develop into so many characters reaching into adult. That is called metamorphosis. But retrogressive metamorphosis is just opposite that. Because the larva lost some character and the advanced character are lost and the larva get in worst condition. That is called retrogressive metamorphosis. Larva getting into an adult or advanced character is called metamorphosis. It's going to down. Our characters are lost one by one. That is called retrogressive. Is the characters. For example, we tell you example here. The nerve is nerve is present in larval stage but absent in adult. That's why the nerve is present in larva but absent in adult. So lost the nerve cord character. So the character lost by the larva and reaching to the adult. Whenever it reaching to adult, so many character are lost. Nerve cord lost. Only small ganglion is present. One example like that. So many characters are lost. That is why this is called retrogressive metamorphosis. Example is called acidia. These are the character of urocordata or tunicata. Okay, students, let's go to the subphylum now. Cephalocordata. See, listen. Cephalo is in a Latin word. That means head. Okay. The chordate means chord is a Greek word. That's a head region consisting the vertebral column or chord or notochord. That is why it is called the cephalocordata. And these subphylum organisms all are marine. They are mostly living in seawater only. But however, it is living in a shallow water. That means not a more depth water. It's only a little bit water, that place only living. And see, this is a burrowing mode of life. They are burrowing the soil and living inside. That kind of life has these organisms. And mostly these organisms are fish-like, very long, lengthy animal, fish-like animal, and a coelomate animal. That means body cavity is present in all these cephalocordate animals. And the cephalocordate organisms have the chordate character. Okay, what are the such chordate character? Presence of notochord is present in head region particularly. And second one, dorsal tubular nerve cord is also present. Okay. Then pharyngeal gill slits. This is used for respiratory function. Okay. Tubular nerve cord used for the integrative function in the body. Notochord is giving the supportive internal skeleton. These three important characters are chordate is present in the cephalocordata. And see, coming to the circulatory system is an open type of circulatory system, but without heart. But a circulatory system is open type and no heart here. Then excretory system is here. The excretory system is carried out by the protonephridia. So protonephridia is a very primitive form of the kidney. Okay, it's a beginning form of kidney which is doing the excretory function. It is the removal of metabolic waste here. Then we see the sexes are separate. That is, the male and female sexes are separately present here. The fertilization taking place in external fertilization. That means both male gamete and female gamete releasing into the water. The fertilization taking place in the water. That's called fertilization is external fertilization. The development is an indirect development. That means the larval stages are there. Not eggs, hatches, not adult-like or parent-like offspring is may not come. There is larva coming there. What kind of larva? There is a free-swimming larva is coming from these phylum cephalocordata. Example, ampiaxis is lengthy fish-like organisms are there. This is the general character of cephalocordata. Urocordata, the notochord is present in the tail. Cephalocordata, sepal means head. The notochord present in the head region only. That is called urocordata and cephalocordata. And let more some subphylums are comes and classes are come. Let us discuss later that, students. Thank you. Today's session over. Thank you. Have a nice study.